blasting hardcore punk on badge frequencies and whatnot.
Hmm. So this must be how Raph and Shiv hacked those drones.
Was beginning to think you'd never figure it out. I think every smartass would have encrypted their comms by now. Anyway, what's the message say?
Raph and Shiv bought a virus, and they're broadcasting it around via an aerial transmitter.
Wasn't there an antenna around here?
Uh-huh. Not for much longer, it won't be.
Those routes are safe and secure again. The contract is closed, and closed well.
It's a pleasure to share the road with you today, sir.
Hey, how have you been?
Very well, thank you. I feel today will prove an exceptional day.
Oh yeah? Any reason why?
I've made a breakthrough in my research. Research and development that will allow the Delamain network to spread its wings.
That does sound exceptional.
I won't bore you with the details. After all, no one likes a chatty driver. We'll talk again soon.
Thank you. Do not despair, V. Today, I give you the chance to help one such divorcee. His name is Mr. Gutierrez, and he is counting on us, V. Of course, his marriage is beyond saving. But perhaps we can retrieve the checks his wife took from him. I am attaching more details.
Diet and exercise.
What's your morning grind?
This is on another level. Like a revelation, a truth, a life mirror.
Like bees? I thought they went extinct ages ago.
World's a garden of Eden, and he's right. Bees included.
Thank you.
I cannot say about Mr. Gutierrez's divorce. Marvelous work, V. Closing the contract.
Thanks.
It's good to see you again.
Something happened?
Come on. Jeff will explain everything. He's just about done prepping for the debate.
Mike,
rescheduled
we're talking
all
about the cornerstone
of
my
today.
Platform.
The
I'm not doing
office
a U-turn just because Night Court.
Here, so
no,
nobody
I'm
will
not
bother
sucking
us.
Anyone's dick just so they can fuck
bother
me
us
in the
doing
ass.
What exactly?
You'll know in a minute.
Look, I gotta go. Make the amendments, we'll powwow later. V, glad you could make it.
Jefferson?
Grab a seat, please. I'll explain why I asked you to come over. We've had a break-in. Not the usual kind, though.
So unusual how?
A couple of days back, dead of night, something wakes me. A noise. I grab my pistol and come out of the bedroom. See a stranger. He looks like he's about to reach for it, so I pull the trigger.
Nail him?
No idea. My head started spinning and I passed out. No trace of him the morning after. I'd like you to find him. Find out what he wanted.
Notify the badges yet?
We don't want any buzz around this. No attention, whatever.
You know. NCPD's full of people who like the occasional stray Eddie.
If we reported a break-in, the media descend on us like a swarm of locusts.
No badges. Gotcha.
Of course, we notified SSI about the incident. Our private security.
Security look into this? Say anything?
This is where things get a little weird.
They claim there's no sign of a break-in or of a shot being fired.
Security cams didn't record anything. Guard outside didn't see or hear anything.
They suggested Jeff must have had a bad dream.
Convenient answer.
Liz gave security the day off so I could call you in.
What did the intruder look like?
I can't remember much. It was dark. He was wearing some sort of mask. Or was it an implant? Couldn't really get a good look at him.
Elizabeth didn't see him either?
I slept through the whole thing. Election season takes its toll on you.
Intruder take anything? Break anything?
Nothing missing.
I haven't noticed any damage either. Jeff must have scared him off before he could do anything.
Said you passed out.
That's right. Just after I fired.
What then?
Nothing. I woke up in bed the next morning. Killer headache to boot.
Any idea how you made it back to your bed?
Nope. None. Elizabeth's at a loss, too.
This, security outfit, SSI. Who are they?
Been on the market the last 15 years. They have clients across the city. If memory serves, they came recommended. An acquaintance. You think SSI might be behind this?
Well, that or someone hiding behind SSI. Anyone come to mind readily?
Weldon Holt? He's my main rival. Fighting for the same seat at the table.
Holt's poll numbers have been dropping.
But it could be anyone, really.
Jeff has many enemies, a lot of them powerful. We could sit here naming names all day.
I see.
That's why I called you, V. I need you to find out what the hell's going on.
Wouldn't mind taking a look around the apartment.
Of course. Liz can give you the tour. Gotta run to a meeting. As soon as you learn anything, let me know.
Come on. Let me show you around.
Right behind you.
We can start where Jeff spotted our uninvited guest. I have to admit, sometimes I get fed up with all of this.
Politics?
So far, we've managed to effectively turn down offers to work with Night Corp, Biotechnica, Arasaka.
So far, you say?
If Jeff can get elected without owing anybody, favors or otherwise, that'd be the real victory. Jeff's office, control room, storage, and flea market crammed into one.
Tight bites. You and Jeff must be putting in serious overtime.
Elections. You don't even have time to think about food, so you just order whatever's quickest. But yes, it's true, Jeff hasn't eaten anything else recently.
Vote for Perales.
We are paying the staffers and for the campaign out of pocket. And we keep all the campaign stuff here. It's cheaper that way. This is Jeff's personal machine. I doubt you'll find anything on it relating to the break-in.
Seems a happy fam.
That your daughter?
Sachi. Oh, we miss her. Her studies took her abroad.
Oh, where to?
Europe. An excellent school. She'll get a good education. I know it's an ocean away. But with Jeff running for mayor, it's just safer this way.
Jefferson, you've come a long way. To get from Haywood all the way here, it's no easy thing.
Yes. If you aren't born with a silver shard, your chances are slim. And if you're born in Haywood, they're almost non-existent.
Wedding pick. Interesting backdrop.
This is where we sleep.
Blue roses. Mind if I take a look around?
Be my guest.
Iron.
Of course, you're
this
right.
This Jeff's?
They didn't have mine, actually. But yes, that's the one Jeff used that night.
Broken.
It was fine a couple days ago. We rarely use it though.
What was
was that?
No fucking clue. Felt kinda good, but weird. Like tripping on acid.
Does that happen to the screen a lot? Or to any of the others?
I don't understand.
What just happened a second ago? Didn't see it?
No? What?
Okay, never mind. We're safe putting your security at the top of our list of suspects.
They violated our privacy. The sons of bitches! Under my own roof!
Wonder how long they've been keeping this from you.
Too long. This ends now. I'm not letting any more of those freaks set foot! Ugh. My head.
Something wrong?
Don't worry about me. Do what you have to do.
Connected to the wall-mounted screens. Wonder where else these cables run.
Tech's practically prehistoric, but it doesn't look older than a day.
Saw something like this back in the war. Transmitters. Militech was using them. Short-range UHF. Signal only travels line of sight, but it can't be intercepted.
Line of sight? Let's look around, see if we can't spot where our receiver's camping out. Got a vision, the receiver. Black van parked next to it. Gotta be our winner. Transmitter's within reach of our mystery van. Wonder if Elizabeth has ever seen the car. There's a transmitter on the roof. It seems to be conveying a signal to a van out front. You know who it might be?
We never set up any transmitter. And I don't know a thing about any van, but my guess is it's SSI's.
Don't really see any other possibility, but we still don't know who they work for.
So what do we do with the transmitter?
Nothing just yet. Let me check the van first.
I'll wait here. Just don't tell Jeff anything for now, okay?
Sure, whatever. I'll call him once I know something more substantial.
That's fine. Just remember, it's the busiest time for Jeff right now. You can always come and talk to me.
Fine. I'll keep that in mind.